हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू सप्तऋषि एस्ट्रोलॉजी एंड टुडे वी आर लाइव ऑन फेसबुक एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट आवर अपकमिंग वेबिनार ट्रिनिटी ऑफ प्रश्न व्हिच वी विल गोइंग टू कंडक्ट ऑन 25th ऑफ जून डे आफ्टर टुमारो. सो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर वेबिनार व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू टीच We are receiving many queries, many questions from the different students and participants. They want to know that exactly what they will learn by attending this webinar. So we will discuss about this. And if you have any other queries or any doubts, so you can just write down in the comment section. So we will take your queries and make sure your queries should be connected with our today's topic, okay, not with the general horoscope analysis and all. And we will try to answer each and everything. And today, Neeraj is also with us. Welcome, Neeraj.
Namaste, Vijay. Namaste to everyone.
Namaste. And Neeraj is also joining us in that Trinity to Prashna webinar. So first, we will try to learn like what basically this trinity means. See, trinity means three, like we have Tridev, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. So trinity means three. So in this specific webinar, as the name already suggesting you, this webinar is about the prashna. Okay, so trinity of prashna means basically we are covering the three different texts, or you can see the three different system of prashna in one webinar. Okay, so it's basically a one day webinar, so obviously in one day it's next to impossible to cover each and everything from that particular system. Okay, so what we are planning to do is, like in the advertisement you have already read, like in this webinar Trinity of Prashna we are covering the Devagya Vallabha, Varahamihira's Devagya Vallabha, and Prithviyashas is this Shatpanchashika, and third one is the Bhuvandipak. So these three are complete book in itself about the prashna. Okay, so anybody wants to learn the prashna and master the prashna, they should read these books. See, basically there are not only these three books, we have some other classical books also for prashna, like we have Devagya Vallabha, we have this Shatpanchashika, we have Bhuvandipak. We can also read Prashna Chandeshwar, Arya Saptati. We can get the book from the name of, I think, Prashna Gyanam. It is Arya Saptati, Matotpal, Arya Saptati. Prashna Tantra we have. Okay, Prashna Marga we have. We have these kind of books. So if you want to master Prashna, you can read these books. Now the thing is, this system of Prashna is basically, there are different systems. Like if you talk about the Prashna Mark, we are doing the course, Prashniyam course. So in that course we are teaching the Prashna system of Kerala. Okay, so basically, we are covering the two books, the Prashna Marg and Prashniyam both. So this course is already started. So we are doing in Hindi and English both. Every Sunday morning 11 a.m. we have English Prashniyam course, and in the evening, Sunday evening 8 p.m. we have Hindi Prashniyam course. So Hindi just started, so anybody wants to join this course, they can still join it. Because it's there, we have covered only one class till now, so you can still join it. So in that course we are learning the basics and some advanced concept of Kerala Prashna system. And in same manner, like we are talking about this Devagya Vallabha and Shatpanchashika and Bhuvandipak, these are not a Kerala system. Okay, so these are something somehow little bit different. But if you read the Prashna Mark, in first chapter itself, author is saying If you want to master the Prashna, you should read Brihadjatak, Krishniyam. Okay, so these two books and Dashadhyay, you should read these three books. Although author is mentioning the different many other books also like Prashna Anushthan and all these things throughout the Prashna Marg, but these three books are building blocks. Okay, so the Brihadjatak and this Dashadhyay and this Devaki Vallabha, which we will cover in our Trinity of Prashna, that is from the Varahamihira itself. Okay, and the second book which we are talking about is Shatpanchashika. And I think everybody knows Shatpanchashika is a very crucial and very important book for the Prashna. Okay, so that we will teach in that Trinity of Prashna. But of course, it's not possible to cover each and every shloka of these three books in that small webinar. So what exactly we do? See, we will teach you the system. Okay, we will teach you the base. Okay, like if anybody had attended that Bhuvan Deepak webinar that we have done for the book review of Bhuvan Deepak, that is already in the YouTube. You can go and watch it. Okay, so in that Bhuvan Deepak book review, so we have covered the many aspects of Bhuvan Deepak. Okay, but in this webinar, we will teach you the framework. We will teach you the base of Bhuvan Deepak. Okay, we will teach you the fundamentals. If you understand the fundamentals, if you understand the structure of that classic, okay, then whatever sutras that is mentioned in the book, you can easily understand and you can easily apply in any prashna. And same thing applies to the Devaki Vallabha and this Shatpanchashika. These are easily available. You can get this book easily. But the thing is, you have to understand the basic structure of this thing. So we will teach you this step by step, like what are the basic principles from these three books. If you can understand it in clear manner, then you can easily understand the sutras and you can easily apply those sutras in any prashna. Okay, like this. So Neeraj, you want to talk about anything? Something
for yes, I will say something about the Shatpanchashika. This is a small book, which is only 56 shloka in this. This book is written by Pratyushas, the son of Varahamihira. And in this book, the 56 shlokas, if you will understand only these shlokas, or otherwise if you will understand the base of these shlokas, then I can tell you in every aspect, you will understand what is the prashna. Every student will understand what is the prashna, how prashna to decode. Like in this, and this system is little bit different and very simple to understand the prashna thing. Like in this book, when you will see simple sloka, but these slokas are difficult to decode. Like in this book, sometimes you will see there are no use of the single houses like Karya Bhav and another things. This book will use only the set of the houses for predictions, like Kendra houses, like Trikona houses. Every sloka will use some set of the houses. Like in this book only, there is one sloka. I will not tell you the full sloka, but I will give you simple glimpse. Like in, if you want to see the two state or two country are fighting or sitting in front of one to another, and something will come as result, one will win and one will lose. So in other systems, you can judge it with one house or with two house only. But in this book, there is slokas that you will see, these are the set of the bhava to see the result. Like partition of whole kundali in some manner, and with that only we can decode what is happening with the questioner. And only these 56 slokas will tell you about every aspect of the life. There is nothing behind with this 56 slokas. Also, we have the book Rohan Deepak. We have done the webinar, the free webinar, the review of that book. In that, we have also given some techniques. Like in this book, the Rohan Deepak, we used the Karakas, also the Bhava of Karakas. So every three book which we are taking, in these three book, we have different kind of the fundamental thing. The base is different. So with the different base, you will get the collective knowledge, and then you will predict. I think if you will do some hard work, then you will be able to predict so many things with the prasna only, nothing another else.
I will also give one example. Like if we talk about this Bhuvan Deepak, okay, so if you understand the basic structure of this particular system, particular book, so you will understand the author is more concentrating on the moon, the displacement of moon, impact of moon, and the Karya Bhava and Karyesh. Okay, so these three are important factors throughout the book. You take any sutra from this book, you have to consider these three aspects. Okay, moon, Karya Bhava, and Karyesh. If you understand the application of these three things, then you can easily apply any sutra from this Bhuvan Deepak. That is that much easy. In same manner, if you talk about this Devaki Vallabha and Shatpanchasheka, again you will get some basic fundamentals and some basic sutras. If you understand those things, you can apply any sutras of Devaki Vallabha and Shatpanchashika, and you can easily use it for any person. So in this particular webinar, we will teach about these things. I will give you another example. Okay, so let's not talk about this Shatpanchashika and Bhuvan Deepak and Devaki Vallabha, because we will cover these three things in our webinar. Let's talk about some other system. Okay, like Jamakol Prashna. So this is something new. I think many don't know about this Jamakol Prashna. So we are also going to do a book review on Jamakol Prashna. We will announce it soon. I think I have already posted the information about the registration link and how you can join this book review. That is already in our Saptarishis research group, so you can join it. And soon we will do the book review, so you can understand the more information about this Jamakol Prashna. So I will give you something basic about what is Jamakol Prashna and what are the basic structure of this. If you understand this basic structure, basic fundamentals of Jamakol Prashna, then you can easily, if you read books and if you learn this technique, then you can easily apply all these principles. Okay, so basically this Jamakol Prashna method is widely used in Tamil Nadu state. Okay, so this is a South Indian based system, Jamakol Prashna, and some people call it Jamakol Aruda. Okay, Jamakol Aruda and Jamakol Prashna both are same. So if you understand, if you try to understand the meaning of this word, okay, Jama Kola, there are two words.
Yeah, there is one another name also. I think some people say it Jamagra Prashna.
What, Jamagra?
Jamagra Prashna.
Yeah, Jamagra Prashna, and like in Karnataka, I have seen many people, they use it Yamakola also.
Yes.
Kola, Yamam. Okay. So there are different variation in name. Okay. But the system is same. Okay, so this is the thing. So in Jamakol Prashna, like if you understand the word Jamam, so it means, Jamam means the 1.5 hour. It means 90 minutes. So you get 90 minutes duration, we call it jhagam. And the second word is a kola, K-O-L, kola. So kola means, in Tamil, it means graha, the planets. So together we call it jama kola. Okay, prashna means we know the horari, prashna. And the aruda is a kind of a lagna that we will discuss in very detail in our courses. So these two words, jama, kola, so these are two words. Jama means 1.5 hours and kola means the planets or the graha. So basically there are 90 minutes, 1.5 hours means the total 90 minutes. 90 minutes equal to jamam. So there are 8 jamams in day and 8 in night. So total we have 16 jamam throughout the day. So this is the basic structure. Okay. So it means if you see the complete structure, so what elements this Jamakol system is holding. Like our students from Prashniyam course, they can understand it very easily. Because this is something similar to what we are teaching in Prashnamal. Okay, so if they know the basics, then they can do it very easily. So in Prashniyam, in Jamakol system, okay, so the elements of Jamakol system are, first you need Udaya Lagna. I think Udaya Lagna is clear to all. Udaya Lagna means Lagna, rising ascendant, or Horare. Prashna Kundali ka jo Udaya Lagna hota hai, usko Udaya Lagna bola jata hai. Second thing is Aruda Lagna. This is very important. This is something different in the Kerala system or the South system of Prashna. Okay, Aruda system. Okay, so this Aruda Lagna and Udaya Lagna, there are two different things. And this Aruda is different from the Aruda of Gemini, which we use in Gemini Jyotish. So that is different one. And this is a different one, what we are learning in this Prashnamar. So we have already covered the different system of calculation for this Aruda system. I think, Neeraj, we have taught them 4 to 5 different variation of calculation of Aruda Lagna. No?
Yes, we are. These are 5. If you will tell me, I will repeat the system. The first is Akshara Aruda, then Swarna Aruda, Kauri Aruda, and also the Sparsanga Aruda and Swarna Aruda. Like this, we have took some Aruda system where any person can define the Aruda and give the answer with the Prashna chart very easily.
Yeah. So we have already covered these things in our Prashniyam course. Different system of calculation of Aruda. So in Jamakol Prashna system also, you have to consider the Udaya Lagna and Aruda Lagna. Okay. And there is another thing, we call it Vithi Lagna. Okay, Vithi Rashi and Chhatra Rashi. In South India, Chhatra Rashi also known as Kavipu. We call it Kavipu also. Kavipu Rashi and Chhatra Rashi both are same. Okay, so for calculation of Chhatra Rashi, you need to understand the Vithi Rashi. So all these things we have already covered in our Prashniyam course. So if you don't know, so you can read about these concepts, Aruda Lagna, Vithi Rashi and Chhatra Rashi. So for Jamakola Prashna, you need all these 3 things. And we are already using these things in our Prashna course. Okay, so Udaya Lagna and Aruda. What is basically Aruda Lagna? Aruda Lagna will give you hints about the past of native. If somebody is asking a question, if you want to know the current status of that native or the past of that native, that you can easily predict through Aruda Lagna. And what is Chhatra Rashi? Chhatra Lagna or Chhatra Rashi will tell you the hidden intention of that native or the hidden question or the question that is not asked. All these things you can understand from the Chhatra Rashi or Kavipu Rashi. These both are same. So all these calculations and how to use all these things, we are already covering in our Prashniyam course. So same things you have to use in this Jamakol Prashna also. And then the planetary configuration of Jamakol Grahas, it will be different. I will show you one example, like how they look and how to use it. And then transit planets. So whenever you create a Prashna chart, so the planets those are actually a transit planets. Okay, but in Jamakola, you have to combine two things. Like when we create a chart, so in chart we have transit planets, and outside the chart you have to mention Jamakola graha, okay, Jamakola planets. So there are two configurations, and then by using these two configurations, internal planetary configuration of transit and external planetary configuration of a Jamakola planets. So by using these two things, we are going to do prediction. So this is the system of that Jamakola things. So I have given a basic overview. So you need to learn Udaya Lagna, then Aruda, then Vithi Rashi, then Chakra Rashi, then the configuration of that chart, internal chart, and the external configuration of Jamakola planets. And one more important thing, Rashmi, or rays of planets. That this is very important thing that many people are not using these days. So, but this rays of planet, or Rashmi we call it, right? You can use it in very beautiful manners. And in Jamakola Prashna, you have to learn all these things. Even we are going to teach all these Rashmi and uses of Rashmi and these things in our Prashna course, not in Trinity Prashna, that in Prashniyam course. Because so these are basic elements of this Jamakola thing. Okay, so if you know these basic concepts now, then you can easily apply any sutra in Jamakola. Like if you read the text of Jamakola, then every sutra or every technique you can easily use if you understand this basic concept. So the Aruda, Vithi, Chatra, and the Jamakola arrangement of planets and the transit of planets and Rashi. These are the basic concepts. So in Trinity of Prashna, we are going to teach you the basic concepts of Devagya Vallabha, basic concepts of Bhuvandipak, and basic concepts of Shatpanchashika. If you master these basic concepts, then you can easily understand each books and you can easily apply these sutras. This is simple. So in same manner, like if you want to see, I can take an example here. So you can share that chart.
Yes, I am sharing. Can you see the screen?
Yes, I can see the screen. Let me check it, whether our Facebook audience able to see the screen or not. Yes, so this is visible now. Yeah. So this is basically, you can see the chart. This chart is in South Indian format. So who don't know about this chart, so they can, they have to know the South Indian system. Neeraj, can you annotate this? So mark kar sakte na?
Yes. I can do.
Lagna, you can mark Lagna first. So who don't know about the South Indian chart, so they can understand it.
This is the Lagna, and Lagna here is...
This is Lagna, but in... Yeah, so Lagna starts from here.
Libra.
But the Mesha Rashi starts from this... is cell ko mark karna ek bar.
Yeah. Mesha Rashi starts from here.
Yeah, so from... In South Indian chart, Rashi is fixed. Okay, so always Aries Rashi will start from this location where we have marked the right tick. So Aries will start from here. So if you want to know the Lagna, that means Aries, Taurus, Gemini, Karka, Singh, Kanya, Tula.
Libra.
So Lagna is Tula Lagna. This is how. Okay. And this whole chart is a transit chart. Now you are seeing this outside planet. I have mentioned the planets outside also. So this is a Jamagraha, the Jamakola configuration of planets. So we will teach these things, like how to configure these planets and these. And then we have to use these outer planets and the inside planets both together. And this is very easy. Okay, this is very easy. If you understand the concept, this is very easy. Okay, so this Prashna chart is to, like some people, we have casted this Prashna to identify the Kuladevata or Kuladevi. Okay. Kuldevta and Kuldevi. Like how to identify the Kuldevta and Kuldevi. So this some person asked this question, and this Prashna chart is casted as per the Jamakola system. Okay. So to find out the Kuladeva or Kuldevi or Devta, we have to consider the Lagna, fifth house and the ninth house. Fifth house and the ninth house. Okay, so these three things are very important. So Lagna means I am talking about Udaya Lagna, not Aruda Lagna. Okay, so Udaya Lagna, fifth house and ninth house, we have to consider these three things. So here you can see the ninth house lord is Mercury. Okay, and if you see the outside configuration, outside means I'm talking about the Jamakola planets, outside planets. So Mercury is debilitation. Mercury is in the debilitation sign outside. Okay, and inside it has combined with the Mars. Inside it is Mercury is with Mars, Jupiter and Moon, four planets are in second house. Okay, but if you see the outside, Mercury is debilitated, in debilitation sign. If you see the fifth lord, because we have to consider the Udaya Lagna, fifth house and the ninth house. So if you see the fifth house, the fifth lord is Saturn. I am talking about the inside configuration now. Okay, so fifth lord is Saturn, that is placed in the Badha house, that is Simha Rashi. I think everybody know about the Badhaka concept. So the Badhaka is, the Badhaka Rashi here is Simha, Leo, and Saturn is placed in that house along with the Ketu. Okay, so both inside and outside, if you look the both configuration, inside configuration of Udaya Lagna and outside configuration of Jamakola arrangement of planets, you will see the Saturn is transiting towards his exalted house Libra in external and internal both. So Saturn is moving towards the exalted sign. Now the Udaya Lagna lord is Venus. Okay, that is with the Sun. Sun is what? Sun is a Badhaka lord here. Okay, so all these things are showing only one thing, that Kul Devta or Devi is forgotten from very longer period of time. Okay, no puja and nothing is offering to that Devi or Devta from very long time. Now if you see the 10th lord, Moon is outside. If you see the Moon, that is in the Udaya Lagna, but in outside configuration, and that is already moved towards his debilitation house. Okay, debilitation Rashi से वो बाहर निकल के आया है चंद्रमा. अगर आप बाहर का अगर आप Jamakola system का देखेंगे तो वहां से Moon is already moved from the debilitation house. So whenever there is an involvement of Moon, either inside or outside, with the Udaya Lagna, then it means this native will get the answer, or he will get the relief, because Moon is a key here. Like I already mentioned, in Bhuvan Deepak also we are giving the more importance for the Moon. In the same system, in Jamakola also Moon is very important. So if Moon is connecting with the Udaya Lagna, either in the inside configuration of transit or the outside configuration of this Jamakola planets, it means we can easily say, yes, you will get the answer. And the whole situation is, he will get the answer, but the situation is, the Devi and Devta is already forgotten and worship is not done for many years. So now second thing is, if you see the Mercury, okay, Mercury is in female sign with the strong Mars. Mars is very strong in the start. Okay, so Mercury is with Moon, Mars and Jupiter. Okay, and the debilitated Moon indicate that the Kul Devi. Now you have to combine these three factors. Okay, Mercury, Moon, Mars and Jupiter. So we will get deity Vishnu, Durga. Two things, Vishnu and Durga. Mercury indicates the Vishnu connection and the Mars indicates the Durga. And the deity, whoever the Kuldevi Devta, that should be very simple without much decoration. There are some deities in Kuldevi Devta system some are very decorative and some are not much decorative. So these Kuldevi Devta is showing they are simple without any decoration. Moon indicates the female deity. Moon indicates the female deity, but without decoration. Now here moon is also debilitated, in debilitation position. So when moon is in debilitation position, so in that case, deity or the idol would be kept in the isolated place in temple. Whenever you see the moon in debilitation sign, so you can easily predict that the idol or the deity is kept in isolation place in temple. Okay, and whenever there is the involvement of planet like Jupiter, the puja will be conducted in regular and proper ways. It means the situation is showing that the Kuldevi Devta deity is still there and puja is already going on. So now they have to search it. Now where they will find it? Now this is a question. Here you can use the Rashmi system. Like I already told you, you have to use Rashmi also. Either you use Jamakol Prashna or you use this Prashna Marga Kerala system. Rashmi is very useful. Now how you can use this Rashmi? So based on the Rashmi, see there is a value of Rashmi for every Rashi and planet. Okay. So Lagna, here Uday Lagna is Tula. So the Rashmi for Tula is 2. And the moon, like here you can see moon is in the outside, that Jamakol moon is in the Uday Lagna. Okay, so we have Rashmi value of Tula Lagna 2, and the moon, Rashmi for moon is 21. Okay, so if you add both 21 and 2, we get 23. So we can say them around 23 kilometers of south, they can find this temple, they can find this deity. So if they go and search 23 kilometers in south direction, they can find the Kuladevi or Devta temple. Now you see the Uday Lagna Lord is Venus, that is in the Makara Rashi, which indicates the direction south. So by this position, you can identify the direction, south direction. Okay, and after when they search this temple in 25 kilometers, in the range of 23-25 kilometers, they found the temple and they found their duty. So this is how you can use this Jamakol Prashna. Concept is very clear. All Karaka planets, Karaka houses are same in the system also. Only difference is you have to understand the configuration of the Jamakol planets in outer circle, and then you have to use with the inside transit planets. With this, you have to understand the concept of Aruda, you have to understand the concept of Chakra Rashi, Rashmi system, all these things. Again, all these things are already mentioned in the Prashna Marga, so you can read that literature, you can find it. So this is how you can use the Jamakol Prashna. So I have given this example only to the purpose that you have to understand, if you know the concept, you can apply any sutras in any system. So like this, in our upcoming webinar of this Trinity of Prashna, we will teach you the basic concept of this whole system. If you Devakya Vallabhaga or this Shatpanchashika and Bhuvandipa. So we have compiled the selected sutras from all these three books, and we will teach you that thing. And after completion of this webinar, just practice this principles repeatedly, one day, 2 days, 3 days, and then read that book. You can easily decode every shloka. So this is what we are going to do in that particular webinar. So Neeraj, do you want to add anything?
No, I think so many things you have completed. So,
and also one or two announcements, two more announcement, like we are going to conduct a Guru Purnima event next month. So soon we will announce it. This time we have more than 40 speakers. It means 40 lectures on 40 different topics. So It's going to be a very huge event. And this time we are also going to introduce a special puja and yajna for all of our audience. And everybody can participate in this. And we are doing a Mahasankalpa this time, so everyone can join it. And also after this, the Trinity of Prashna, we are going to conduct an Ayujyotish webinar. Ayujyotish is basically a medical astrology webinar. So last month we have covered sun and moon, I think, Nirish, right?
Yes, yes.
Sun and moon we have covered. So this webinar is in Hindi. English we have already covered. So this month we are going to teach Mars and Mercury, no?
We are doing Mars and Mercury, and also we are doing a special mantra of that is the Dhanvantri mantra.
Dhanvantri mantra. So we are going to talk about Dhanvantri mantra and its application.
How to use it.
And its application, how to use it. So this thing we are going to teach in our upcoming Ayurjyotish webinar. So this is the thing. So I am not seeing any portion related to the concept or topic. Some people are posting their personal queries. So like I already announced in the beginning, I will not take any questions. So if you have any question related to the concept related to Prashna, you can ask. We will answer it. Okay, so yeah. So these are the things. So we will end the session now, Neeraj. And tomorrow we will also, tomorrow we will again meet. And we are planning, like from today onward, every day we will do small 10-15 minutes astro discussion, and every day we will come up with new topic. So tomorrow we will take the case studies of diabetes, like how to identify diabetes in the horoscope, what are the planetary configuration, and how to go step by step. So we will teach these things, we will learn these things in tomorrow's live session that we will do in our Saptarishi research group. So like this, if you have any questions, or if you want to suggest any topics, you can drop us in comment section. So we will take all those queries in our live session. Okay, so Neeraj, we can end this session now.
Yes, we can end. And
thanks for being with us. And tomorrow we will again meet in live session, same time.
Yes. Thank you. Thanks to everyone.